So off screen, I've gone ahead and completed the positionsaver.c# file, and that's simply because there's quite a lot of code involved, and the best way for me to explain it to you is to write it out first and then explain how it works. So we have our positionsaver script file, and one of the things I've included here is the usage of the system.io namespace, because we're going to be using a class from that namespace. So I have created mainly two functions. One is save object and the other is load object. So the save object will convert the object into JSON data and then save it to a text file on the computer. So what we're doing here, you can see inside this function, is we're grabbing the position of the object and we're setting it to the transform position. So this function will be called when the scene ends and the object is destroyed. We record the last position inside the last position variable and the last rotation inside the last rotation variable. And I use the output path to construct a string that references a file on the computer. So in this case, we're going to be saving the data to the objectPosition.json file. And this will be saved inside the folder application.persistentDataPath. Unity populates this variable automatically and it varies depending on the computer, but it will always reference a valid folder on the hard drive. Then further down, we have this writer object. So this is used from the system.io namespace, and I'm creating a system writer object. This will allow us to save a string to a file. So I'm creating a new writer object that you can see here. And then when I'm writing the line, that is the text data to the file, I'm calling upon the JSON utility to convert the class to a JSON string, and that is the string that is output to the file. I then finally print a debug.log message simply to confirm where on the hard drive the file has been saved. Then further down we have the load object function. This simply does the same thing but in reverse. Rather than save the data to a JSON string and then outputting it to a file, it takes a file as input, reads the string, and then reconstructs the object. So I'm creating a stream reader here from a file on the hard drive. I'm reading that data into a JSON string, and then I use the JSON utility from JSON overwrite to take that string and then to output the results in the current object. And then finally I close the file and I update the position of the object based on the last position and the last rotation. The load function should happen when the scene begins. So notice here further down, in the start function, we are loading the object from the file, and the onDestroy function, which happens at the end of the scene, we are saving the position of the object. So if I go back to Unity here, closing this code, and I return back to Unity, you can see that when I press the play button on the toolbar, the position of the object changes. So I've selected the object, and now he's looking here in this direction. If I, for example, move the object over here, and I rotate him to face, let's say, in this direction, looking like that, and I end the scene, his position will be recorded, and in fact down here you can see the file to which it was saved, but now if I press play again, he will in fact be restored to that position, and he is looking in that direction. And if I scroll down inside the object inspector, you can see that the position saver component records all of that data. So that's how you can go ahead and load and retrieve data to and from JSON files.